kana tayona he chonataha osho kana aya osho ota ata osho na he chonatakaha. Beautiful day to you, dearest impeccable warriors of light. Welcome to Impeccable Warrior of Light channel, where we are all on the fast track and you are on the fast track to peace, healing, and enlightenment when you implement the teachings that were bequeathed to us by my gurus from India and the great Mayan peace shaman, Don Jacinto Tzab Chac. This is a place of healing. This is a place of miracles. This is truly a fast track to an expansion of consciousness. And it was my great fortune to meet Don Jacinto and receive the final touch in my training, in my spiritual training, which then prepared me to live as an impeccable warrior of light. And that's what we share with you here and on our website and in the podcasts and in all the various ways that we bestow upon you these great teachings from the masters, these timeless teachings. So praise, praise, praise to dearest Don Jacinto Tzab Chac. I had studied with my gurus from India, and they had purified me by giving me the great practices of chanting, by sharing with us the sacred science of sacred sound, chanting, and teaching us about seva, selfless service, and reminding us to live as holy beings in this beautiful world and to perceive it as beautiful no matter what we had to go through. So they prepared me with their great wisdom, their own great purity, and the huge golden heart that they radiated love from to all of humanity and all creation. And then arose within me the desire to study with a shaman, a healer, but not just any healer and not just any shaman. I told the universe that I chose to be accepted by and trained by an impeccable teacher, by someone that could heal everything and everyone if it was God's will that it be done so. And through grace, because I was charged with grace due to my guru's grace, and with that grace, the way opened up for me to meet Don Jacinto. And Don Jacinto was just such an amazing, amazing, amazing being to study with. I was able to accompany him on ceremonies. He asked me immediately after I asked him if I could be his student, he invited me to sit in on the sessions, and I started my training. And through Don Jacinto, I was awakened to the reality that darkness does exist and that the light can be triumphant against that darkness. People came to see him with so many types of serious cases. And he, since he was 15 years old, he was practicing. In another video I shared that when he was 14, he started studying with his teacher, Don Feliciano. And at 15, Don Feliciano said, "That's it, you are ready. Now go, go serve the community, go serve the world, go and defend the light." And Don Jacinto spent the rest of his life every day, every day, every day working for humanity, every day serving the light. He took care of his village. He made sure there was running water. He made sure that the teachers showed up for the schools, and people came at all hours of day and night. And no matter how tired he was, he would attend to them. He was a simple man, just so humble, and such a beautiful heart dedicated to selfless service. He would take his herbs of the ruda, for example, or albahaca, which is basil, and rue, the sacred plant of rue, powerful sacred medicine, and he would start sweeping the person, or he would be able to see immediately what was causing that situation. Was it witchcraft? Was it an imbalance in the physical body? Was it that the person crossed an energetic field someplace, and there are many places where you can cross energetic fields or energy such as an evil wind or wind that's charged with illness. There are many ways to lose your balance in daily life. But God, Great Spirit, Divine Mother, has provided the antidote, the remedy, and it is the shamans, it is the master healers. So whether it was a baby that was colicky, or whether it was someone like this man that came that was affected by witchcraft, or someone that was having terrible luck, or someone was living in a haunted space, Don Jacinto knew what the remedy was. And then he would prescribe that. And then when those actions were taken, miracles took place. So for example, with the man that I referred to as to being the victim of witchcraft, first of all, there's a lot of people that practice the dark arts, that practice black magic. And there are many people that envy you, or they're just malicious people. They're possessed by malevolent spirits. So this particular man was walking home, and these three old ladies asked him to please bring something down from a tree. And he said, oh, I'm sorry, I'm really in a rush. I can't right now. I'll come back another time. Well, this irritated them, and they were practicing witches. So they put a hex on him. They cursed him. Very fast, very soon, his health began to deteriorate to the point where he couldn't walk. He had no control over his physical functions. His family used to have to hang him over the hammock, and that is how they propped up his body. And through grace, they knew about Don Jacinto, and Don Jacinto began to do the clearings that a peace shaman administers. He began to do the limpias over this man with these holy prayers, these shamanic soul retrieval prayers, and the man regained his health. Whatever the case was, if it was divine will to save that person, to help that person, Don Jacinto was able to do it. Every day, he was administering to humanity, whether it was consultations, or whether he went to somebody's home because the home was haunted, or perhaps it was a new home and they had to bless it. Perhaps it was a prosperity ceremony for the land or for the home. In the Mayan tradition, whenever someone's going to begin to farm land, then there are specific rituals that are done to then bless the place, to offer offerings to the energies that live there, the energies that govern that area, and to, of course, to drive out the dark forces, bring in the light, and he would do that. Once, for example, there was also this case where these young men were in the forest, and they were very boisterous, and they had no respect for nature, and they had been drinking. So mysteriously and mystically appeared this old man and told them, young ones, you need to keep it down, keep down the noise and be more respectful. And they didn't care about the wisdom, they couldn't hear it. So he went on and disappeared. Then without them realizing it, they were suddenly trapped, imprisoned in a mystical realm where no one could see them or hear them. Their family became very worried, and search parties were sent to search for them. And when they couldn't find them, then they conferred with different shamans and Don Jacinto. And everyone agreed that the men were alive, but they were in this realm trapped. And now no one could reach them, no one could see them, no one could hear them. All the other shamans said they could not help. But Don Jacinto said, I need 9 days, but it can be done. So for 9 days, Don Jacinto was praying, 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 praying. And on the 9th day, he said, you can go look for them now. They are in such and such a place. The people went to look for the group of young men, and they found them and brought them back. Don Jacinto was a servant of the light. He was an impeccable warrior of light. He served the light with all his might, day and night. Everyone that I met continually praised Don Jacinto and told me a miraculous story. Don Jacinto was a traditional Mayan shaman, and so he performed the traditional offerings in the Mayan tradition, including the rain ceremony. He was able to dig a little hole wherever he was going to do the ceremony and invoke the sacred waters, and water would start bubbling up through that little hole in the ground to supply him with the water he would need for his ceremony. He was a miraculous being. The list of miracles is too long, too many to recount here. But I will just share with you that it was my great pleasure to train with him, that I saw a man that was humble, devoted, worked tirelessly for many of his appointments. Many times he had to go hiking long distances to where that location was that the ceremony would be held at. And he did it again and again and again. From age 15 to his 70s, he was working in a way that required great sacrifice, great energy, physical energy and spiritual energy. And he did it. And he did it laughing, smiling. He loved to tell jokes, and he just loved to communicate with those around him, and they loved him. And they all knew what a great, 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 great being he was. Shukana tayona he, tionataha, makanaha tayo o shukana a makanata yo o kanaha, shunata he aha.
The universe. I am the pure heart. I am the brave heart. I am the bright light of the universe.